Hello everyone, welcome to this episode of How to Tutorials by Levonotion Studios. My name is Lydia and in this video I'm going to show you how I paint my character's skin in Blender 2.91. Let's get started. So this is the character we'll be painting. See, she's very cute, right? So I'm going to delete her skin texture and we're going to recreate it all over again. So this is her skin, girl skin, so I'm going to remove that. So this is what we have now. So I'm going to create a new material, create the texture, and we're going to paint her skin together. So the first thing I'm going to do after deleting the skin is create a new one. So a new material, this is new material, just call this new material. So now we have this. So the next thing to do is, let me go to shading, go to UV. So we have this principal BS there. So after this, if I try to go to textures and I'm on in textures and I try to clean, I try to paint, it's going to give me missing texture detected. That means there's no texture. So to paint in Blender, you need a texture. So that's the first thing you need. So I'll go back to shading. Then to create a texture, I'll just click on Shift A to add. Or you come here, add, you go to textures, image texture. Or Shift A, go to textures, image texture. So this is the texture we'll be painting with. And I will just click on color and connect it to the base color. So right now we don't have any texture, it's just empty. So you can select from whatever you have here, you can create a new one. So I'm going to create a new one. So I'll click on new girl skin. Let me add new. Then I'm going to make this 2K 2048 by 2048. So you can just make this any color you want for a start. So let me get it a bit darker. You can always change this later. So I just click on OK. So this is what we have now. So just one single color. It is not different from just having something like this here. So this and this, they are similar, just color. So now we need to start painting. So go to the texture paint. You can also paint it here. Go, just click on tab. Or control tab depending on your settings, or you come down here, you come up here, object mode, you click on texture paint. So I just use tab texture paint, then you start painting. But I prefer to go to the texture tab here. So this is it. So right now the color we have on our brush, this is the brush here, is this. So if I click, I start painting this color. So click on N to bring up this N panel. So here you have your texture. As many textures as you have, they will be listed here. For now, we only have one single texture, which is the new girl skin that we created together. So that is listed here. Then we have the brushes. You have some. You have just texture drawer here. And you can create more depending on what you need. Then the brush settings, the color picker, the color palettes. And most of the things I used are, I use this brush settings, these brushes, the color picker, and sometimes I use textures if I want to transfer from a texture to the character, and the fall off. So from all this type of fall off, the smoothest of them all is this. So I use this for painting. So the default is this. Then you can I changed it to this, but what I'm going to use for this tutorial is this one, is the smoothest of them all. Let me just click. It's very, 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 very smooth. So that's what we use. So now I'm going to use mouse. So I'll be using mouse for this video. I have a tab here, but I won't use it because most of you don't have a tab. But if you do, fine, it's going to work out fine. It's going to work by using the graphics tab, but I'm going to use the mouse. the previous skin I removed was painted using mouse. So a graphic stamp will only make your work faster, but you can also use mouse to achieve anything you want. So now, if I will use the same skin from the previous skin, I can just pick the skin here. See, this one says girl skin texture, which was the first one, and this one says new girl skin, which is the present one. So if I want the same skin, so I can just click on S to pick. You can use S to pick any color. When you are over it, when you click, it creates it here. For my skin, for my elbow. I don't know why it's not picking for my skirt, but anyways, so just pick from here. So I have that, so I can add it to my palette. So create a new palette is very simple. Just delete this and click on new, and you have a palette. So I can rename this to girl skin pal, just to have something unique and what you can remember. So this is the base skin. So now I can just like start painting on her body. Let me remove the smokes. So I can just decide to start painting on her body. But since I want to change the whole color for my body, this doesn't make sense to start painting the whole body when I can easily just use this fill tool. So it's going to fill up whatever color you have on the character. So I'm going to select this color, then fill it up. Yeah, so that's the color. It's quite different from what we have, the dark skin. So just paste. And just paste. But if you want to fill up everything at once, come to image on that view. You want to check display texture paint UV. So it's going to remove the UV. Then when you click, it's going to fill up everywhere. So another thing to watch out for before you paint, before you start texturing, you need a very good UV. If you don't know how to create a UV, check out our old tutorial on how to create UVs. The link will be in the description below, and I think I'm going to put it up here somewhere here. Oh yeah. Anyhow, so just click, check on the video and you see how you can create UV. So let me show you the UV of this character. So this is our skin UV, this is our head, and you have other parts. So this is our head. So the UV is quite good, UV map. So make sure you have a UV already. So you need a UV and you need a texture, image texture to paint. So let's say this is what the skin shade we are going for. So I just go to texture and I want to start painting the face. So I just click on this pink color. I think that's what I used the last time. So just start painting. So it's quite straightforward. So in case this is what you want, I think that's what I used the last time. So if you notice, the strength is not on one. That's the difference between using a mouse and a graphics tab. If you are using a graphics tab, just click on this. It's going to regulate the strength depending on how much pressure you exert on the stylus. But if you'll be using mouse, the pressure is one. Whatever you click is what you get. So you can reduce the strength down to a very low value and just start painting. So that's just what you do. Now to paint the mouth. Just paint our lips. Let me increase the strength. So you can paint both in the viewport and in the texture paint. So yours might be in maybe mask or view. When you're in view, you can't paint. or when you are in mask, you can't paint. So, but you have to be in paint to be able to paint in this texture editor, image editor, yeah. To be able to paint in your image editor, so just and use F to change the radius of your brush. So F to take it, you either move your mouse left or right to reduce the radius of your brush. So just start painting this. The funny thing about Blender, the way it works now, you can't use mirror in the image editor. You can only use mirror, doesn't work. If you check here, when I paint in one part, it reflects on the other side because my symmetry is active. I have it on the X axis. So because I have it on here, that doesn't mean it's going to work in the image editor. So that's one thing you should watch out for. It doesn't work. So they are not linked. And the brush size, see how small it is here? See how big it is here? So just have to watch out for that and just work manually. So whatever you're doing, on one side, you do it to the other side. So the inner mouth is looking good now, so we can just continue to paint the character. Let's reduce the strength now. So it's quite harder using mouse, but to get the job done. So our lips is too pink. Let me just let's change it. So to pick any color, just click pick. So see, I'm filling out the painting. I'm having this issue here because of the bleed. The bleed is too much. See, take it back. So let's say 6. So I can clean this up by just selecting this color. Sorry. Yeah, that is out. So she looks like a clown. Okay, let me redo this. Let me reduce the lip color too. Yeah. Just change the lip color. Yeah. So now the ear. So this is just a basic way of texturing, nothing serious, nothing too complex. So just to isolate. I'm going to leave a link below to that will show you how you can do that. undo. So now you notice that this thing is not really, I can decide to just paint out this, but there's another tool I can use. I can use this soften. So it's going to soften everything and blend them together. So you can use this to blend things together to make them work more. Let me go back to the brush. Where is the ear? That is one ear, and this is the other one. So let's say we're done. She's not as beautiful as the other one, but you get the whole gist. I can make this less red and slip into her, but you get the gist. So that's it for this video, and thank you for watching. Hope you've gained one or two things from this, and don't forget to like the video, subscribe to Levonotion if you've not done so, and until next time, stay true to your creativity. Bye bye.